Have you ever looked into a true mirror? Now, the way that a true mirror works is it reflects your light so that you see yourself the same way that other people see you. Okay, it sounds cool, right? I'm James, the mad scientist. If you didn't see my last video on plasma, please watch it. I recreated plasma from this Tesla coil, and plasma accounts for 99.9% of the visible universe. Okay, so how does a true mirror work? Now, normally when you look into a mirror, a normal mirror, you see a reflection of yourself, of the light of yourself. And that reflection is actually an inverse version of you from front to back. It's not a flipped version that a lot of people think. That's just a human misconception that we get from when we look at other people face on. So a true mirror, when you actually look at it, there's two mirrors at a 90 degree angle, and the seam has been completely removed from the center. These things are really hard to get hold of, because the manufacturing process to remove that seam is really hard. So the two angle, the two mirrors actually reflect your light twice so that you see yourself in the same way that other people see you when they look at you. So if you imagine looking into a normal mirror or a car wing mirror, you see the car registration number behind you. The registration number's flipped, right? It's the other way around. So I brought some friends along to try this so we can see the reflections and their reactions, and we can see if you think this is worth looking at.
Wait, don't look into it now or no?
Yeah. Is the height sort of right?
No.
How'd you look? How'd you find it?
Oh my god. Okay, no, it's so different. Oh my god, it's like really looking at yourself. Okay. Just look straight in there, it's so weird. Oh. Oh my god, have you done it?
Yeah.
What did you think? It's
f***ing weird.
I'm like, it's so...
That is trippy, mate. I almost feel as if my face has been punched and pushed to one side, as if I'm talking like this, but it's just because it's been flipped.
But it's just something, it's because you look at yourself in a different way than what you're used to.
I don't know if I like it or not. I can confirm the face is asymmetrical.
I love that, that's brilliant.
Have a seat, Jay. Don't look in the mirror just yet.
I can see my face symmetry is not symmetric.
Anything else?
It's very strange to see myself like this.
Yeah. So Matt's going to find this really difficult, I think.
Yeah, it looks weird.
Just look at it.
I don't like it.
Okay, so now I'm going to have a look in the true mirror for the first time. Wow. No, I'm joking. The things that I'd sort of see on that side are on that side, but pretty much it's just exactly what I expected. So yeah, I can play around with it. It's very interesting how it works. You can actually see no seam whatsoever in the center. There's nothing. And you know, when you move to one side, you move to the other. I'm honest, like, I'm a little bit underwhelmed with just the whole thing. I was expecting to see something like cool or really different. Can you see that? Okay, so look, yeah, that's one mirror, okay? The word's Jack. And then through the true. So there's 1,000 different reactions that you're gonna get from from different people, but I'm here to explore and see what my friends' reactions are. And this might sound like a vanity project, but it's not. It's a science project, because anything to do with photons of light, reflection, refraction, I love, and anything to do with seeing things more real, more true, I think is all in line with science. Now, every time I think about this a bit more deeply, it gets a bit more interesting. So when I point the arrow up, it goes up. When I point it down, it goes down. When I point it right, it goes left. When I point it left, it goes right, which is what we'd expect, because when we look at people, we invert their image that way. Now, if I point them the arrow into the box, then you can see there's four arrows, which again makes sense. 360 degrees divided by 90 degrees at which the mirrors are at
gives us 4. And a normal mirror inverts from front to back, so the only actually inverted picture you see is directly in front. Now, this is the thing that I find really interesting. If we close off that mirror, you can see that we aren't seen. And if I close off that mirror, you can see that we aren't seen. So this mirror on its own cannot see us, and this mirror on its own cannot see us. The light is reflected off of that mirror that way, the light is reflected off of that mirror that way. So if those mirrors were on their own, they wouldn't see us. The light would come across here. The reflected light would come across here. So the cool thing is, it's almost like this is making a wave of light out to us. It's almost like you're getting free light. Oh, it's so cool. Now, the way that I understand this is that when you look into a mirror, the mirror reflects your light at the same angle that the light hits it. So if we take a point, I can see this mirror, but it can't see me on its own. Now, if I look at this part of the mirror, let's say I'm looking at that part of the mirror at 45 degrees, it reflects the light off to this mirror at 45 degrees, and depending on that angle, right, it's always going to be, if I'm looking at a different part of the mirror, say over here at a different angle, it's always going to reflect it at the angle. So let's just say, for example, I don't know, let's say it's 70 degrees, and it reflects it off at 70 degrees to this mirror. That's why I can then see it, because now the other mirror is doing exactly the same thing. The other mirror is reflecting. So a really cool trick you can do, if you cover your eye, or if I cover my eye and I move, the seam in the center is directly in the center of my eye. It's like the Mona Lisa. I'm moving and the seam is moving with me, because it matters. All that can see anything is my eye. The rest of my body cannot pick up the reflection of the light, right? So I'm looking at that and it's looking back into the center of my eye. So if I'd now distort this mirror so I can show you how that works, because you won't see this moving unless I move you. So if I move you now, you'll notice that the seam in the middle stays in the center of the camera. So, and that's the same as looking at it with your eyes. So that gives a really good idea and perspective of how this works. Right, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll be making some more very soon.